The third Sunday in Advent, Year B. From the Gospel according to John, among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal. In the name of that one, even Jesus, who with the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, now and forever. Amen. When John the Baptist speaks of being unworthy to untie the thong of Jesus' sandals, he's not just being humble. He's also speaking about the intimacy of exposing another person to immediate contact with the world. On this Rose Sunday, we've prayed the Magnificat, in which we hear Mary, the mother of Jesus, recognizing just what kind of world she will be bringing him into. Mary is untying the sandals of aloofness that have separated and shielded God from immediate contact with the world. God will encounter and be vulnerable to a world where the proud and the mighty beat down the lowly. A world where there's hunger for food and hunger for mercy. We live in this world. Indeed, it's because we live in this world that God chooses to enter it. God comes among us to provide for us as we mourn. God comes among us to give us a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. His coming provokes acknowledgement that we are a people whom the Lord has blessed. How then are we to cultivate this acknowledgement so that we may exult in our God with our whole being? How now are we to follow Paul's advice to rejoice always, pray without ceasing, and give thanks in all circumstances? We start by allowing ourselves to be deeply, thankfully amazed that God's feet have touched and been pierced by the same ground we walk, though we are neither the Messiah, nor Elijah, nor the prophet. The first step is to enter into that pain, saying, "Here too is God." The second step is to allow ourselves to be comforted in that pain by Jesus' embrace, our wounds bound up and our nakedness covered with the robe of righteousness. And the third step is to return that embrace, holding fast to what is good. The Lord has anointed us for our comfort and for our commissioning, that we might share God's liberating joy with all who have very good reason to mourn. Let us therefore rejoice. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.